Henry Fillmore wrote 15 trombone smears. That's what we call them. He called them trombone rags. And one of those was Shouting Liza Trombone. He gave the names to the pieces, the names of minstrel characters. There was Shouting Liza Trombone, Miss Trombone, Ham Trombone, Boss Trombone, Bull Trombone, Dusty Trombone, and Lassus Trombone, etc. But the original title of this thing was Hallelujah Trombone. But that didn't last long because, you know, it's built around the Hallelujah chorus, hurrah, hallelujah. But it didn't last long because remember that Henry's dad founded the Fillmore Brothers Publishing Company as a religious music publishing house. And when he found out that Henry had used the Hallelujah chorus for a trombone rag, he considered that sacrilegious. And so Henry was forced to recall all the pieces printed under that name and give it a new name, Shouting Liza Trombone. Now, I saw him conduct that here in Columbus at an American Bandmasters Association concert back in 1952. And that's when I opened up my biography of Henry Fillmore with that story. And that was the funniest thing I have ever seen in my life because Henry was very overweight in his old age. And he came out on the stage in this white Palm Beach suit. And he looked at the audience, he says, "It's awfully hot in here. Do you mind if I take my coat off?" Took it off, he had big wide red suspenders. And when he conducted, I mean, he had backfield in motion. and both sides were not in coordination. But it was the funniest thing I've ever seen in my life. And I talked to a number of band directors down in Florida who knew Henry Fillmore and had him guest conduct their high school bands. He had a special way of doing this. And it went like this. He stretched out the introduction, started out with this big, long glissando, bah, hallelujah, then bah, 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 and he'd fade away. Then he would turn around to the audience and say, "Now there will be a short prayer for the trombones." And then the band members would all pretend, you know, abba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba, and then he would shout, "Ho!" And hurrah, pum-pum-pum, hurrah, pum-pum. Really tear into it. That's the way I saw him do it. And you might not know this, but at American Bandmaster Association conventions, they have a rule, no encores, except when Henry Fillmore conducted. And when he did Shout and Liza Trombone, he came out into the audience. He was sitting two rows in front of me. This was over at Ohio State in the old men's gymnasium. All the way down to his seat, sat down, and the audience was not about to let that end. So he had to get up and do it over again. And like I say, they had it. In the ABA, it was a tradition. No encores, except Henry Fillmore. And that was a kiss of death because nobody would ever want to follow Henry Fillmore on a program. But anyway, that's what I was so enthralled with the title of the original piece. That's what I used on my biography of Henry Fillmore, Hallelujah Trombone. I'm not making a sales pitch.